Hello again. Today we're going to be talking about getting free internet in 2025. I'm going to be going over four different methods to get free internet. While making this video, please understand that everyone's situation is different. So some of these may apply to you while others may not. But these are the four most common ways to get free internet in 2025. And hopefully this will help somebody get connected. So method number one is free dial-up. Yes, it still exists. Yes, dial-up still exists. And the most common one we can use is Netzero. Netzero does allow 10 hours a month free dial-up. Please note that you must already have a landline to get free dial-up. As stated before, everyone's circumstances are different. You may have a landline, you may not. If you do not have a landline, go ahead and skip to the next thing, because getting a landline today is probably going to cost you just about as much as getting cable internet or DSL. But surprisingly enough, this still works today. And it's good for visiting basic sites, so like your news sites, your CNN, BBC, Yahoo News. It's good for email services like Yahoo Mail, Gmail, Hotmail, whatever free email service you might have. Basic searches on Google and Bing. Other simple forums like for weather and online banking. So things that have a lot of text and or pictures. Please note that video streaming and even music streaming is kind of out of the question for dial-up. It's too slow. So text and pictures, internet. I, of course, will leave a link in the description below on how to get free Netzero dial-up. So this brings us to method number two. If you have a student in kindergarten to 12th grade, you can apply for free 4G and 5G internet through T-Mobile. So let me go ahead and get to that site here. It's called the 10 Million Project. So as long as you have your student's identification number and all the required information, you do have to provide your income. You do have to provide that proof that you do have a child that is a student. But this is actually a really good one because you get anywhere between 100 to 200 gigabytes per year, which is pretty substantial. You can do some streaming. You can pretty much do whatever you need to do. And if you go over the 200 gigabyte, it's, I think, $10 for another 100. So the first 200 are free for the year. If you don't go over that, you've got free internet for the year. And they send you a hotspot for that, and I'm going to show you what that looks like right now.
Okay, so this is the device that T-Mobile sends you when you qualify for the free internet as a student or a person in your home that's a student. It's a very, very basic device. You just connect to the Wi-Fi. It gives you the password when you go through the menu. It has one button for on and off and menu scrolling, and that's it. It has a charge port. Unfortunately, you cannot tether that port to a computer. This is just strictly through Wi-Fi. And when you open it up, it literally just has the battery and the SIM card. And that is all it has. It doesn't have any antenna plug-ups or anything. Like I said, it's very basic, but it is free 4G and 5G internet that you can get if you're a student.
Okay, so how is the speed on the T-Mobile free hotspot for kids from kindergarten to senior year? I've gone ahead and connected the device that I've shown you to my computer. And let's go ahead and test the speed out. Okay, as you can see, it does come up as T-Mobile. So not too bad for free internet. Usually I get about 25, depending on the area I'm in with this. It is broadband, so the it does have at least 25 down and 5 up, which is the minimum requirement for to be considered broadband or high-speed internet. So yeah, I will of course leave the links in the description below so you can see if you qualify. Like I said, as long as you have someone in the household that is in kindergarten to 12th grade in the United States, you can apply for this and see if it's a viable solution for you. Okay, so that brings us to method number three, parabolic outdoor antennas. So, sometimes you can get connected to free Wi-Fi in your area, especially if you live in a highly populated area and there are a lot of businesses around you. So, just to give you some examples, these antennas range greatly. Obviously, you have a basic one here for $16, and then you have this one on Newegg for $300, and one on Amazon here for $179. It does take a little research and it does take a little tinkering. What I recommend is taking a small antenna or a small Wi-Fi adapter, whether you can even use your phone and go around your area to see what is available to you. So if you walk to a business and it has free Wi-Fi and it's not too far away from your home, you may want to try one of these antennas and point it at that location to try to get a free internet connection. And keep in mind, lots of businesses and lots of facilities have free Wi-Fi or free public Wi-Fi. And depending on the area, you can use a free VPN and go to pretty much any site that you want to go to. But just to give you some examples, you got Peet's Coffee, Wendy's, Panera Bread, Dunkin' Donuts, Target, KFC, Tim Hortons, Lowe's, Coffee Bean and Tea, Burger King, Best Buy, McDonald's, Subway, Arby's, Taco Bell, Starbucks, Walmart, public libraries, and other various locations. Even doctor's offices and dentist's offices tend to have free Wi-Fi. So if you have one in your backyard, sometimes you go in, say, hey, I'm considering getting a new dentist or a new dermatologist, whatever. Take some information down, and they usually will have the Wi-Fi password posted somewhere. So just walking in and getting the password is a great way to get connected. It's public Wi-Fi. It's free. It's in the airways, so I see no issue with using an antenna to get connected if you are trying to get free Wi-Fi. All the companies and businesses that I had mentioned, I'm going to go ahead and post in the description below, along with their speeds that they tend to have at those locations, along with some extras.
So I'm out in the garage, and I'm going to just show you the antennas I use for my car when I'm getting free Wi-Fi. I don't have an antenna on the roof, but this is what I use to scan around my area to log free Wi-Fi connections and different connections that I can use if I need to. And it's just a small antenna, two antenna array that I got rigged in the trunk, and then it can broadcast to my phone or my laptop if I want. It's very similar to the war driving of the early 2000s using NetStumbler. But yeah, this is what I would use to see what's in my area, and then you can get a more advanced antenna to put on the roof and do more testing. Always check the return policies on the antennas, because if you put down a significant amount for the antenna and get up on the roof and you can't get any Wi-Fi, package it back up and return it. So always check the return policy. Okay, so on to the fourth and final method. I'm in my garage again, and this is for just text messages and email that are free, completely free. If you have an amateur radio license, you can actually use a radio to send and receive text messages and emails. And there are two methods to go about this. The first method is called APRS Droid.
Frequency mode.
So basically, I can go ahead and set up my cable. I'm on 144.390. That is for the APRS. Let me make sure it's high enough here.
Friday, rain and snow in the morning, then rain in the afternoon. No snow.
Okay, that's high enough. Switching back to that channel for the APRS. Now this sends at 1200 baud. So it is slow, but you can send a small email pretty much anywhere in the country with this. Now, I'm not going to get too much into it because there are plenty of tutorials for this. I'm going to start the track. Need to turn on my location. Yep, we're good there. I have send message to. I'm going to use the call sign, email, -2. Message, the first part of the message is the email. So I'm going to use my old Netzero one, and we can check that in a moment. .com. Space, and then the message. I'll just say, got here safe. Done. Send it off. And it has 1 of 7. It's going to attempt to send the email 7 times. I didn't have the camera pointed at the radio, so it didn't flash red, showing that it was sending. So I'm going to leave this going until it shows that it sends another one, another packet. And this is great if you're in the middle of nowhere and have no cell service and no internet provider. It is a great way to send email and text messages. Unfortunately, you cannot really receive them using this method. For that, you would need a program called WinLink, and it is a little bit of a different setup. Oh, there, we went ahead and sent again. And just so you know, the antenna I'm using is about $10, the radio I'm using is about $25, and the cable I'm using is about $12. So it's a really cheap method to send email and text messages. Now, to send a text message, I'm going to go ahead and explain that in a moment after we check the email. So we're going to go ahead and see if that email went through.
Okay, so let's see if the free email went through on APRS on the ham radio. So I'm going to go to my free Netzero account and check my email. There is my call sign. And there's my message, got here safe. It says, do not reply. You can see what my location is here, etc. So to send a text message through that method, whether you're using the WinLink software for the free email client, or you're using APRS Droid to send something, the best way to do that is going to be, for the email, you're going to put the phone number and then the carrier. So unfortunately, to send a text message or receive a text message through the email clients, you do need to know the person you're sending it to. You need to know their carrier. So for instance, you'd put their entire phone number with area code. I don't think you have to put the one in front. Sometimes you do. But it's, for instance, AT&T is at txt.att.net. Here's the one for T-Mobile, Verizon, Virgin Mobile, and there are a lot of carriers like Cricket, and I'll go ahead and post as many as I can find in the description below for this. I really hope this does help somebody, and I understand everyone's circumstances are different, so sometimes free internet is just needed. It is an important part of our lives, whether you're applying for jobs or in school or trying to just get by at the time. And that concludes our video for 4 methods of getting free internet, email, or text messaging. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please feel free to post them below. I will get back to them as soon as I can. And if you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, share, or give a super thanks. Until next time, have a great one.